Hello, my name is Ron Veen. As the technical director at the Naval Undersea Warfare Center's Newport Division, it is my responsibility to ensure that we remain the Navy's technical steward in the undersea domain. I believe it's critical for our workforce and the local community to understand what this warfare center does in the bigger picture, in support of the United States Navy. Fundamentally, the question is, why do we have a Navy? I'd like to try and answer that question for you. So here we go. A little known fact. The United States Navy began right here in Rhode Island, way back during the American Revolution, when Rhode Island native Esek Hopkins became the only Commander-in-Chief of the Continental Navy in 1776. The sloop, Providence, was one of the first ships in Hopkins' newly formed fleet. Civics 101, however, tells us that the United States Constitution was adopted in 1787, and Article 1, Section 8 reads, that the Congress shall have power to provide and maintain a Navy. So why do you think a fledgling country like the United States would need to spend precious resources for a Navy? Well, back in the day, our founding fathers realized that the United States was a maritime trading nation. Our economy relied on free trade, and that to conduct that free trade, we needed unfettered access to the sea lines of communication. A full 90% of our goods and services came by way of the sea. And that remains true today. In the years following the signing of the Constitution, the United States would see its merchant fleet disrupted by piracy along the Barbary Coast, the northern coast of Africa. Congress enacted the Naval Act in 1794 and ordered the construction of 6 frigates to deal with this piracy. Do you recall the United States Marine Corps hymn, "From the Halls of Montezuma to the Shores of Tripoli"? The Tripoli, referenced in the Navy's first action at the Battle of Dern, which basically ended piracy along the Barbary Coast. That crucial trade route at Gibraltar was once again open to free trade. Fast forward 200 plus years, and the United States is still a maritime trading nation. The United States economy is more than ever tied globally, and about 90% of the world trade by volume travels by sea. About 80% of the world's people live near the sea, and about 70% of the Earth's surface is covered with water. The economy of our nation requires that these sea lines of communication remain open, with unfettered access to all. When I hear the United States Navy, a global force for good, it's not just a slogan, it's a fact. The Chief of Naval Operations recently published A Design for Maintaining Maritime Superiority 2.0, which provides guidance relative to the Navy's mission to conduct prop and sustained combat at sea. Our Navy will protect America from attack, promote American prosperity, and preserve America's strategic influence. Our naval forces are the finest the world has ever seen. No one can match our warfighting capability. There is more capability today in our 287-ship fleet than what existed during World War II when we had over 1,000 ships. The reason is simple: technology. We are able to harness technology to improve our warfighting systems in ways that are second to none. And this gets to why we have warfare centers. To remain number one in the world, the Navy needs warfare centers to understand the technical dimensions of military problems, to partner with industry, academia, and other warfare centers to harness technology to develop solutions to those problems, and to certify, at the end of the day, that the safe and effective solution has been provided to the warfighter. One of two divisions, the Naval Undersea Warfare Center, Division Newport, has expertise in submarine and surface ship undersea warfare systems throughout the full spectrum of systems engineering lifecycle, from science and technology, research and development, systems acquisition, and lifecycle support. With headquarters in Rhode Island, the Naval Undersea Warfare Center Division Newport operates detachments at West Palm Beach, Florida, and Andros Island in the Bahamas. Remote test facilities are located at Seneca Lake and Fishers Island in New York, Dodge Pond in Connecticut, and Bug Springs in Leesburg, Florida. The work we do at Division Newport is more relevant today than it's ever been, and we're seeing our work recognized around the world in congressional testimonies, fleet actions, the media, and right here in our own community. But mostly, we are seeing our work result in improved capabilities to the naval warfighter. As the Newark Division Newport Technical Director, I'm not only proud of the accomplishments of our 3,500 employees, but I also appreciate the dedication and commitment from our many support contractors as well as the continuing support we receive from the local community. Together, we have made Newport the technical center of excellence for undersea warfare. Naval Undersea Warfare Center Division Newport, undersea superiority today and tomorrow.